explanation and justification in negotiations. From the negotiation perspective, as we started earlier, the primary motivation to use deception tactic is to gain a temporary power advantage. And the negotiator may make the decision to use such tactic casually and quickly in order to seize a tactical advantage. Or after long and careful evaluation of the various options and their likely consequences. When a negotiator has used a tactic that may produce realistic reaction, the negotiator must prepare the defense to the tactic used to himself. I see myself as a person of integrity, and yet I have decided to do something that might be viewed as unethical to the victim or to constituencies and audience who may express their concern. The primary purpose of these explanations and the justifications is to rationalize and explain and excuse the behavior. To verbalize some good and legitimize a reason why the ethics was necessary. There is an increased esteem of research on those who employ unethical ethics, tactics, and explanations of justification that can be rationalized them. Most of the following rationalization has been adapted from the negotiations book and the research on lying. The tactic was unavoidable. Negotiators frequently justify their action by claiming that situation made it necessary for them to act the way they did. The negotiator may feel that she will not be in full control or her action has no other option and hence should be not held responsible. Perhaps the negotiator has no intent to hurt anyone, but was pressured to use the tactic by someone else. The tactic was harmful. The negotiator may say that he did not rely on trivial and not very significant. People tell while lies at all times. For example, you may greet your neighbor with a cherry. Good morning, nice to see you. When in fact, it may not be a good morning and you may be in a bad mood and you wish you hadn't run into your neighbor because you're angry about his dog barking all night. Exaggerations, bluffs, and peeking at the other party private notes during negotiations can also be easily explained away as harmless action. Note, however, that this particular justification interprets the harm from the actor's point of view. The victim may not agree and may have experienced significant harm of the cost as a result. The tactic will help to avoid negotiation consequences. When using this justification, negotiators are arguing that the ends justify the means. In this case, the justification is the tactic help to avoid greater harm. It is okay to lie on an armed robber about whether you have hidden your money in order to avoid being robbed. Similarly, negotiators may lie on any of the other means end up tactic as the justification if it protects them against even more undesirable consequences should the truth be known. The tactic will produce good consequences or the tactic is on trustworthy movement motivated. Again, the end justifies the means, but the positive sense, as we stated earlier, the negotiator who judge a tactic on the basis of consequences is acting in accordance with the tenets of the act utilization, that the quality of any action, given action is justified by its consequences. The act utilization. Utilitarian and will argue that certain kind of lies or means and tactic are appropriate because they may provide for a larger good. For example, Robin Hood tactics in the which someone robs from the rich makes the poor better off. Another tactic that's help explain. In reality, most negotiators use deceptive tactics for their own advantage, not for the general good. In this case, others are likely to view those actions as less usable than tactics that avoid negotiation consequences. They had it coming, or they deserve it, or I'm just getting my due. All of these justifications are variations on the theme of using lying as deception either against or an individual who may have taken advantage of you in the past, and against some generalization system of authority. It's possible to be noted that the problem of national erosion of honesty in the United States. Increasingly, people believe that it's appropriate to take advantage of the system in various ways, through tax evasion, petty theft, shoplifting. Inappropriate declaration of bankruptcy, journalistic excesses, and distortion in advertisement. The decade later, newer statistics suggest that the problem has increased dramatically, almost in every front. They're going to do it, so I'll do it first. Sometimes negotiators legitimize the use of the tactic because of he or she anticipate the other and pretends to use similar tactics. Let's take a break.